send a very strong message that we don't think there's any place for these drugs and we believe they should be taken off the marketplace.
The world was looking to us. New Zealand had the answer. They're not all the same. There's a million different synthetic cannabinoids out there. This is just one or two that are particularly dangerous. And unfortunately, we're choosing them randomly by handing the market to our criminals to run.
I think Peter Dunn has struck the right balance. If you set laws which are too tight, then you empower the black market.
When synthetic cannabis came along, I thought, okay, let's build a factory and let's set up quality control standards that are as good as the pharmaceutical industry's got, so that you don't end up with one batch that's too strong and one that's too weak, and we make sure that everything's tested. But there were like dozens and dozens of other companies out there making products as well who, they didn't do any of that. They just bought the stuff, slammed it on the herb and put it out to market. We wanted quality control standards. We wanted the safest drugs possible. We identified maybe 1 million different drugs that can work at the cannabinoid sort of receptor sites. And some of them are very dangerous and some of them are quite benign. So we needed to sort of weed out those dangerous ones and just choose the ones which are not so harmful and give people access to those. The government could see that as well. The advisors agreed to that. We created that legislation to allow us to do proper testing.
A lot of people saw the legal cannabinoids when they came along as providing an alternative much more safely.
We were just finished.
When you've just been run out of your own country, just think, where on earth am I going to go? Let's go to Thailand, it's always been nice there.
People just almost have to smoke it on the air. They'll wake up in the middle of the night, they'll carry on smoking it. It's a terrible, terrible drug.
It's horrible. It's horrible being vilified by such tragedy, you know? And that was the message I was trying to get out then. A drug is going to come that is going to kill a whole bunch of people if we don't do safety testing.
Results in them convulsing, vomiting, having seizures, being admitted to hospital. And a couple of months ago, there was a spate of deaths.
Well, I'd like to see us resurrect the Psychoactive Substances Act, because that regulated market does give us control. But if you have a regulated market where you test for safety, you know what's involved, you know what the risks are, you can regulate accordingly. At the moment we can't do that and we play catch up when tragedies occur.
You know, the horrible thing is this. Right now, all across Europe and the United States, they're on the next wave. The next wave is not synthetic cannabinoids, it's synthetic opiates. And I can't see what is going to stop that coming to New Zealand next.
It was kind of prophetic. I had like a premonition that even when things were going really well, that I had this horrible feeling that we were going to get run out of town. The story of an alchemist who was trying to save the world, where there's some aliens attacking and they wipe everyone out, everyone else is asleep, and the alchemist finds a way to defeat the enemy that was coming in, and then the townspeople wake up and they think that the alchemist was the cause of the problem and they run him out of town.